this video about my photo gear. Now I got some kind of job from my company to shoot one project, which is a really, really massive and huge job to do it. So I have to update my photo gears, and I just want to share with you guys. So the update is in this bag, yeah? I didn't open this bag. I just had a bag from the shop with my motorbike. Back in the time, of course, like everybody, I'm used analog cameras. My first analog camera is some kind of Ricoh, really plasticky and autofocus, really simple gear with 35mm fixed lens. And then I updated to the Minolta X700 back in the days. And I realized that the Minolta cameras, they're very good and they're very professional. So later on I updated my analog camera to this Maxim 7, which is, believe me guys, it's a very professional, it's a beast. It have a lot of digital goodies. It's almost looking like a DSLR. So this is a very nice analog camera, what I'm still using even today. And for that, of course, I have different kind of films, mostly for artistic kind of looking. For example, I have this really nice 50 ISO black and white film, Ektar 100. Color, very, very, very beautiful film. The colors and everything is just like, wow, I really like it. Then I have from the T-Max again 100 ISO, what I mostly am using. This is again black and white, but professional film, de facto artistic black and white film. This is 400 ISO, so I can shoot with that almost in a night. Is also black and white, and it's have some kind of really nice grainy on a negative. The whole picture is coming to really artistic. So this is my hobby setup for art kind of photos. Yeah, in 2010 I bought this Alpha 580 from the Sony. I think in the same year they released the Alpha 900, which is really a beast, and even today it's a really great and professional camera with 24 megapixel full frame sensor and magnesium body and blah blah blah. I'm still hunting for it on eBay. Maybe one time I will get one. So why I choose this camera back in the days in 2010? Because I used the Minolta Alpha FA mounting system, so for that I have a lot of lenses. Back on the days, everybody is get crazy on a Canon 5D and a Canon 350D or something like this, and I'm not. So I stay with this system because all of my old Minolta lenses, it's absolutely 100% matching and fitting to my Sony camera. I really like this camera. It's a survivor because I fell down this camera many times from scaffold on a construction. I'm almost drive on it with a bobcat, and it gets cement, it gets wet, it gets water, dust, whatever. And nowadays this camera is popping on eBay for about 100 euro, 150 euro, something like this. If you are interested on Sony Alpha cameras, you can pick up this because 7 years in a construction and it's still working. So this Minolta camera, this is a beast. This is a king of autofocusing in an analog world, and as you can see, it's fully packed with digital goodies, dual LCD display system, a lot of controls, jog wheel, whatever, and date printing on the film, exposure compensation, flash compensation. Somebody on YouTube already did some kind of video about this camera. I will place the link here in the description. I have this really nice 50mm autofocus lens, which is going down to 1.7 on aperture. If I attach this to my digital body, you can see it's really small and really light. And but the 50 millimeter, it came to like 75 millimeters. So it's almost the perfect for do portraits. The depth of field is, it's absolutely amazing, really nice. So this is a really, 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 really great lens. And of course, this is not the Minolta G, it's the normal Minolta AF, but let me tell you guys, with 1.7 of aperture, you can do with that absolutely amazing pictures. The next lens is, again, it's not the G Minolta lens, so it's normal AF lens from Minolta. And why I like this lens, because this lens have a macro function. So this is the lens what I'm using for show you guys close-ups from PCBs and parts and whatever. And it's have a very nice zoom range, so it's going from 28 to 85 millimeters. So on the Minolta, I can use this absolutely perfectly for portraits, even if it's just going down to 3.5 on aperture, but it's still a usable lens. And this lens is also good for construction, because in a construction you have to take shots really wide, and then you have to take a short one from long distances, because maybe you cannot reach the place where the work is going. So this is a really great zoom range for me, for my usage. The next one, it's a kind of candy, but this is done by Tokina, and this is the ATX series lens. Unfortunately, when I bought it, I forgot to check if it's the Pro version or not the Pro version, so I'm a bit confused with the line of this ring, because the Pro versions, they have gold here, and the normal ATX versions, they have just yellow. Doesn't matter, I really like this lens. It's a fixed 2.8 on aperture. The bokeh on this lens, it's really classical and really nice. And I found, why is it? Because so this is how some kind of issue can be benefit. In this lens, it has some kind of wobbly-bobbly on a front element, which is the focusing element. So because of that, if I'm shooting on a wide aperture mode, so get some bokeh, because of this flimsy-blimsy, everything which is behind the subject, it's even more mushed, more blurred out, and it has some kind of really interesting taste of the bokeh with this lens. So I really like it. Mm-hmm. Now we're talking. This one, it's a professional lens. It's going from 80 millimeter to 200 millimeter. And this lens I'm using also for portraits. I can use this lens even to take a picture about the person who is sitting in the crane, which is, let's say, 40 meter or 60 meter high. So I really like this lens, and of course this lens is also 2.8. You see, so this is the ATX Pro, so this is the Pro, and you see this one have a gold ring on the front, and it's working really nicely. And if I'm attach this one to the my old analog Minolta, and if I'm using the 400 T-Max black and white film, believe me guys, this system can produce a really, really, really nice picture. I really like it. The rendering from this lens, it's kind of classical looking, so it's not these super sharp and super clean and super transparent pictures. It's adding some kind of yellowish looking to the picture. I think mainly because what kind of glass they used in the past and what kind of coating they used in the past. This flash we find in a garbage. Somebody closed some photo lab or something like this here in Berlin on our Frankfurt Alley, and we find this one and this one in the garbage with together with some kind of really weird analog photographing gears with magnifiers and I don't know all of this, and we cannot use it, so we give it to somebody as a gift. But I keep this one because this is made by Minolta, for Minolta, so it's working on my Minolta analog camera, and it's also working on my Sony APS-C digital camera. So let me attach it, and this is how it looks together. Time difference between the two, it's about 20 years, and the protocol that is used in this camera, it's the same what the Sony is using in the digital camera, so this old flash from the garbage, it can be controlled by two. This is a really professional flash. It's really, really a beast. You easily can shoot with that 500-600 pictures with one battery charge. And it's really fast, and it's providing a massive amount of light if you want to. But of course, you can limit it to really, really tiny lights, and you can do a delay and whatever. So this is a really, really nice flash from Minolta, and it's still working on my analog camera, and it's still working on my digital camera. And you can rotate and tilt the head like this or whatever. It's heavy, it's massive, and it's durable, and whatever. This is really great. You have a different kind of filter on our top, and remote triggering inputs, and continuously power input, and wow, I'm really like it. So with this, you can place this one wherever you want. For example, in a construction field, I can leave this one close to the wall with like this, close to the wall, and I can ignite this flash from remotely with my garbage flash, something like this. And on this one, I can place this filter. So then, when I do a shot, color of the bricks and everything is just popping out. And here I have this other one that we also find in a garbage together with this one. This is a really cheapo, plasticky, Chinese something. By the way, I think it's some kind of German product from the past. Mostly I'm using this one to do a light calculation. Every gear that I'm using here, and as you can see here, it's just, it's not this high and professional level gears, but I still can produce with that a really decent pictures. This is the grip what I'm using for shooting portraits and nothing fancy. It's a really simple extension, body extension. Filters, I really like it, and it's cheap, so it's running about 40 euro or something like this, a set which is contain ND, color, whatever. Really great. So you can call me kind of Sony fan for the reason, as you saw, because I really like the Minolta alpha lenses. I'm stick to this Minolta system mainly because of this great analog camera, and I was really happy on a pass when I read the article about the Sony Iscam Fusion together with the Minolta, and on that time I just crossed my fingers. I hope the Sony will came out something digital camera which is the same like a Minolta, and then bang, they came out, and then this is the time when they started with the Sony A100 with the 200, and after Canon and Nikon is just blown out. I really feel kind of sorry because the Nikon and the Canon, they're a great company, but nowadays it looks to me they lost this game absolutely, and the Sony is just leading the industry with technology, with developments, with lenses, with everything. It's just amazing. So Sony, if you see this video, I went to you because of the Minolta. Time to open the bag. yesterday I waked up and I start to think how I will shoot this project in this construction field, and it's massive amount of pictures from different distances and whatever. So then I realized I need a lot of lens, I need a better camera, what I have now, I need a fastest camera, I need more light sensitivity, I need more megapixel. So then when I waked up, I just jumped on my motorbike and I went to the Sony shop. This Sony shop here in Berlin, which is in the Sony Center, it's absolutely amazing shop. You guys, if you are here in Berlin, you must go into. And by the way, this is the shop where I'm going almost yearly to buy new gear, new professional gears. And if you were evil, not, but the lady who is inside, she remembered me. She came to me, hi, how are you, da, 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 what. Yeah, you can see, Sony store, Berlin, so it's absolutely original. Ah, on the end, why I went into the Sony shop. I start to look on eBay, then I read a lot of negative feedbacks on these eBay shops who is dealing with new Sony gears. And most of the time, the gears, what they bought from the European shop, it's the origin is in China, so then they cannot apply the warranty to this product here in Europe. So the price is not everything. Other guy in other eBay shop, he wrote an absolutely negative feedback. For example, he wait 3 weeks for the product, and the other one get an opened box with some kind of weird scratches on a camera. Next one, he even didn't got nothing, he just get back the money, but because of the money transfers and whatever, he lost a lot of money on our bank fees. So be careful. So this is why I'm not went to the eBay way. So to get to work my old Minolta flashes with my new camera body, of course I have to apply some kind of adapter. So now all of my Minolta flash will work with the old one, with the analog, and with the new gear, with this adapter. So this is the 4 adapter. It gave me back the autofocusing capability on my old lenses. Let me attach to it this 50 millimeter lens. Mm-hmm. For example, just check how big is and how wobbly. Oh guys, it's even better than the original body. It's like, really nice. The next box is again adapter, but this one is the LA EA3. Which of course don't have this autofocus driving mechanism and this autofocusing system. So this adapter is made for the digital lenses from the Minolta AF system. Oh yeah, this is nothing in a way. And here the autofocus drive system is missing, but I'm loosed, but I'm not loosed. This lens with this adapter, with the new body, plus focus peaking, plus focus magnification, then I really can get really fast adjustment on a manual focus. And by the way, guys, because I came from the analog world, of course, I'm more familiar with the analog focusing and analog lens adjustment. So why? No, I know. Okay, guys, the price difference between the two is about 200 euro or 180 euro. Okay, but still, I don't understand why I get a really nice case with the other adapter and why I not get with this. Mostly maybe because people even, they're buying for each lens and they left on a lens. I no have clue. Had a feeling in a shop, what if the adapters and the old lenses are not fully working together, and I don't want to really destroy my job, which is starting on Monday. So I'm a bit scary. So because of that, I bought this Zeiss F4 lens. And now you will cry, oh, why not the 2.8? And yeah, guys, everybody have a limit of money, and I also have. So Yeah, I saw over there the new G-Master series, and it's like I just get a heart attack on a price, but I will buy it. So yeah, at the moment I just can buy this one, which is about 800 euro, something like this. So it just can go down to the F4 Zeiss, which is good and absolutely so. It's not a garbage, so it's not a kit lens, yeah. So it's Zeiss optics, and quality is absolutely Zeiss. It's like this one is more light. I think it's contain more magnesium and more aluminium parts. This one is pure steel. It's steel and steel and steel everywhere. It's really old technology. So what I have now, F4, yeah, and F2.8. But if you compare this to the kit lens, what you can get with the E-mount system, you wanna see how much cost this flash. This one, it's cost on a market about 700 euro or 600 something, I don't remember, but it's over 500 euro. This is the flagship from Sony. So this is the flash, you see that? So this is the flash, this is how much I paid for it, 1 cent. In Sony representative shops, no, they are running some kind of action or sale. When you buy certain cameras, then you will get a professional flagship flash to your camera. So I'm really, really happy with that, because I'm already thinking on that. Oh, now I have to buy a body, and sure be sure I have to buy a new flash. I got for free. And she said to me, I will be really happy with that because it contains something. This flash, even if it's the hot newest technology, I can adapt to my old Minolta. Fantastic. I'm so happy, really. Look at this. So what I can do with this? This one, it's unbelievable. This one. So, and this is official, so it's not Ching Chang Chung, yeah? It's done by Sony. So, you see that? Minolta analog body. Guys, my best buy in this year. Oh, guys, the touch and the feel, it's like, it's absolutely amazing. This is something you have to feel and you have to touch. 120 degree, okay, then bounce. Plus, what I'm missing from the old Minolta, I can do with that a macro. So prism, plus white bouncer, built-in video light. So this is not only a flash, this is also a flash and video light source. Plus, let me show you other goodies. You not just can tilt, okay, the head, you also can do like this. But what I'm missing from that is I can't turn it, so I can't turn the head. So now I have like a combination. This one, of course, I can turn, yeah? So I can do this kind. But with this one, I can do only this kind. If it's mounted on a camera, then if I'm turn like this, then I get almost the same results like what I get with this. But this one, I even can turn it to the absolutely back. So now, I can absolutely hit the back wall. The new one is just can go to 120. I'm really happy with this kind of movement, because when I'm using this one in portrait mode, of course the best one if the camera is staying on a portrait mode, but the flash I can use on a top, what I cannot do with this one. So, guys, you see now the goodies. Sony, Minolta, It's a fantastic system. Now with this old flash and with the new flash, I really can do whatever I want to do, including video light. So now let's attach this one to my old analog Minolta camera with the original Sony adapter. Perfect, and lock it. Guys, I hope everything is working. So I'm sure the TTL will work, but I'm not sure the remote triggering and the multiple flashes will work with my old analog Minolta camera, but I will update you guys if you want to see this. But look at this flagship, new modern flash from 2014. I think this is when they made the first one, or 2012. Oh my old Minolta analog camera, absolutely amazing. Okay guys, it's really a joke. For this small adapter, they give you a branded bag, yeah, with Sony. And they not give nothing for this. it's like, I have here something else. What is this? Oh guys, nice, really nice. Thank you very much, Sony, for giving me this for free. The adapter contain kind of magnet here. The magnet is coming here, and inside there is some kind of sensor. Then a flash is now. You attached the bouncer to the top of it. Thank you, Sony. Oh. Then I put this one into here. Nice. And this one to here. Nice. Yes. Yes. Maybe I will. Yeah, I will do something like this, I think. Yeah, I'm sure I will do. Or here. No, like this. Now it's too bulky. Yeah, this is the best. Okay, this is what I will do. And yes, here is when my dream is came to be reality. Yes, I bought the Sony A7 R Mark II. I never opened that one. So now what I get? Maybe now the Sony 580 camera is became a bit obsolete because of the ISO performance and the speed and the crop sensor, whatever. So I think this camera, I will give it to Razi as a gift to use it on construction fields. From now, this will be my main photo camera. And it came with some kind of small brochure about lenses. I will not stamp to hand for the Sony A900 camera on eBay, because nowadays the Sony came out with really great lenses for the normal alpha mount. This is small. This is small. So let's compare this one to my Minolta. Yeah, bit small. I have a feeling like bit small. So let me attach to it this FA lens from the Zeiss. Not bad. It's like, I think it's okay. I don't know. I think I have to get used to it after these big bodies. Actually, you know what? I'm like it. I don't want to do a review. It's just my first, really first impressions. But I'm really impressed on a quality. Guys, this is something really professional system. First switch on, yeah. Oh, okay, I'm English. Yeah, the Sony menu is kind of weird. Everybody is saying that, and absolutely right. Oh, guys, I have to learn everything about this camera. Guys, this F4 lens, it's surprise, but is working really well. So let's change now this Zeiss lens to something old. So let's now drop on it my 50 millimeter Minolta AF lens with the LA3 adapter. But guys, this bokeh on this body with this old lens, absolutely amazing. Oh yeah. The transmission from the focused area to the unfocused area is less than 2 centimeters. With this old Minolta lens with this adapter, you just can do a manual focus, but because you have here a focus peaking, maybe you can see. You see this yellow things which is running on it? So with the focus peaking, you almost get better focusing than in the past with autofocus. This is 3.5 lens, of course, full frame. As you can see now, all the autofocus points here, it's provided by this adapter. Yeah. Okay. And now the big gun is coming. Now it's really challenging because the Minolta lens adapted to the adapter and is speaking with the body, and the body is controlling the flash. So if everything is working, then my TTL flashing also will work perfectly. Yeah? Oh, guys, it's unbelievable. Oh, I'm so happy with this. Yeah, I see here some kind of moire on the barcode, but I focused, if I remember good, I focused here somewhere. Ah, oh, guys, fantastic. And I don't know if you can see it on YouTube or not, but the feel of this flash, it's absolutely right. So the TTL and the TTL function, it's absolutely working perfectly. So I get almost a perfect shot. With this one, let's see the histogram. Almost perfect. So in this scene, I have a lot of black things and I don't have really white. So the wall is even not fully white, it's kind of really like light gray. And this is what I see also on a histogram. So Sony, great job with these adapters. So now the time is to place the old flash, which is this Minolta, to this Sony body and do a shot with the same skin over to one to the two. So it's half power. Let's go back. So this is with the Minolta. This is with the Sony. I think the old Minolta, even it's a bit colder, 42 megapixel, guys, is something unbelievable. And my old Minolta flash is still working on it. Oh, guys, unbelievable. So this is a really, really tiny crop of the original picture. Let me show you the full original picture. So this is 42 megapixel, okay. Then I go into, maybe here you can see it's like a tiny bit of portion of the original picture, and unbelievable. Guys, I'm so happy with this system. Thank you, Sony, and thank you, Minolta, to develop this fantastic system. Ah, I didn't try out this big baby, full frame, big zoom lens on my Sony. And yeah, so they fixed the issue. Unbelievable. Guys, I'm totally wrong. In a full frame body, this adapter don't have 3.5 limit. So I can go down to 2.8. Unbelievable. I'm so happy. Tokina. Yeah. Tokina lens. In 2.8 with autofocus. Thank you very much, Sony. You fixed this issue with the LR4 adapter. So what I have now? A full frame body, full frame optics on chip. I still can use my analog camera. And if I want, I still can use the APS-C sensor camera. I can use all of my flashes, including the old Minolta. I can do a wireless triggering. I can go to the new Sony FE mount system. And because I have a Sony E mount system, I can buy almost any kind of lenses on a planet. So until now, I have to filter down on the eBay, on the optics, only Minolta AF. And now, because the Sony E-mount is so versatile system, because of the distance of the sensor to the body, I can buy any kind of lens for my new camera. I'm so happy with the results. Sony and Minolta, thank you very much. Really great job. Absolutely fantastic job. What you guys did, it's something really amazing. Thank you very much. I get the flash for free with this great body. Thank you, Sony Shop in Berlin, to give me 20% discount and gifts, whatever. I will come back to you. I will buy the Sony G Master lens. Don't worry, the whole range. Each month I will buy one by one by one. And guys, it's a beast. See you next time. Bye.